Today, I will take you to the steps of creating free Google Cloud Platform account with $300 free credits.
My name is Rohit Garg and I welcome you on our YouTube channel, Decode ITES.
Decode ITES provides you single learning platform for multiple IT technologies.
Today's topics are Google Cloud Platform, free account, always free services, $300 free USD credit, best practices of creating and using GCP account, how to create free account with $300 USD, walkthrough of Google Cloud Console dashboard.
Let's explore what is GCP free trial account and its features. GCP offers you free trial account with $300 USD credits to each new individual account created on GCP. This is marketing strategy to welcome learners, students, developers, to try GCP environment and build new or shift existing product and environments on GCP. That means Google welcomes everyone to use these free services and see what all features and what the stability they are providing and what options they are providing so that you can plan to develop your new products or your existing products to move on Google Cloud Platform. Business accounts are not welcome for free. This service is only for individual accounts. Google will ask you for credit card details for registration and charge a nominal fees against it. Please don't worry because it will be refunded automatically. Your credit card details are safe with Google and Google will not charge anything against it until you manually upgrade your account to paid one. That means your free tier account will remain free until and unless you manually upgrade it to paid one. As we say free, it comes up with lots of restrictions because Google can't allow you to use their complete infra in free. So there are lots of restrictions so that small applications or developers or learners or students can test their application over Google Cloud Platform.
Google Cloud Platform free tier comes up with two features, always free and $300 USD credits. We will discuss the each one in brief in coming slides.
Always free, as name implies, is always free with some restrictions. Any usage of always free services will not be charged under your $300 free credits. It's always free beyond your free trial period of 12 months or 365 days. Google provides a list of services with some quota limitations or restrictions that you can use freely. Let me take you to Google Cloud Platform always free page and see what all services are available and what the quota limitation of each services. Google Cloud Platform free tier account. As mentioned in the slide, this account comes up with two features, always free products and $300 free credits. In always free products, you will get a chance to use Google services and products including BigQuery and Compute Engine completely free up to their monthly quota limit. Usage of these services will not be charged under your billing account or from your $300 free credits. So let's explore what our products and services are listed under always free. There are a list of products and services under always free, like Cloud Run with 2 million requests per month, Firestore with 1 GB limit, Compute Engine, One Machine, your cloud storage of 5 GB, your cloud functions of 2 million invocations per month, Kubernetes with one Jonas cluster, App Engine with 28 hours per day, that means you can run two machines, Stack Diver, 50 GB, BigQuery till 1 terabyte, Vision AI, Speech to Text, Natural Language, and their list of services. You can also click on View Details for further details of Always Free account. So this is Always Free. Always Free program provide limited access to many Google Cloud resources free of charge. Resources are provided at intervals, usually monthly. Always Free resources are not credits. They do not accumulate or roll over from one interval to next. There are multiple details regarding free usage program and this is free usage limit, like App Engine, F instances 28 hours per day, 9 hours per day, B instance 1 GB of address data. Auto machine language, 5,000 units predicted per month, and this list is quite long. and this is very crucial to know, exceeding always free usage limit. Any usage above always free usage limit is automatically billed at standard rates. You can help control cost by setting up widget and alerts through Google Cloud Console. That means any of the services, if you are using under always free and you breach the monthly quota, Google will automatically charge you against your billing account. To ensure it will not happen or you will get the timely notification, set up budget and alerts that we will see in next session, how to set up a budget alerts. $300 free USD credit. This is the second feature of Google Cloud Platform free tier account. Google is giving $300 as a free credit for each new individual account created on GCP. Credit will be converting to local currency based on your profile when you review it in billing section. This is to ease the user experience. You must ensure to upgrade your free tier account to paid one before the end of free trial period of 12 months. Once your free trial period is completed, Google will stop your all the resources in free tier account. Google will give you 30-day grace period to renew your account or to access your data. After that, everything will be deleted. Full details of free tier account is available at Google link. Let me take you to Google link and we will see what all free services and free options are available. The next feature of Google Cloud Platform free tier account is $300 free credits. New customers will get $300 to spend on Google Cloud Platform during their free trial period. You can click here for more details. So, Google Cloud free trial gives you free resources to learn about Google Cloud services by trying them your own. Whether you are completely new to platform or need to learn the basics, you are established customer and want to expand a new solution, the Google Cloud free tier has you covered. The Google Cloud free tier has two parts. 12 months free trial period with $300 credits and always free. We already discussed always free products and services. Let's explore about $300 free credits. So this is something we already mentioned, that Google will ask you to submit your credit card details, but it will not charge anything without your confirmation or until you upgrade your system automatically to paid one. Also, at the registration time, it will ask you a minimal amount, but that will automatically get refunded your account. End of free trial period, we already discussed, you must upgrade your system before end of trial period. Google will shut down your resources at the end of the trial period. Google will give you 30 days of grace period. This is very important, recovering data. Whether you are in 12 months of trial period or 30 days of grace period after that, in case you want to recover your data from Google Cloud because you don't want to continue or whatever reason you have, you need to contact Google Cloud Platform billing support to export such data. You can't directly copy any data out of Google environment to your local system. Also ensure, once your grace period is ended, Google will not be able to recover your data because your data will automatically be deleted after 30 days of grace period. Best practices of creating and using GCP account. Before we start our demo of creation of GCP free tier account, I will suggest you to go through with the best practices and try to adopt as much as you can. I will suggest not to use your personal email ID for GCP Demo Lab. Create new Google account for GCP Demo. This will help you keep both accounts separate because your personal account may be linked to multiple apps or social platforms, and using the same account will may lead to data sharing kind of issues. So we will create the separate account for this demo. Always use Incognito window or private browsing. This will help you to ensure that no cache or passwords will be saved. This is to secure your system. Configure your account for two-step verification. Google's gives you a feature of two-step verification. That means along with the password, you need to add additional Google code. This is a second layer of security. Save your account for password stealing or hacking. In case your password is stolen by someone, then even he will not be able to log into your account because he will not get the G code. You need to provide verification code for two-layer verification or two-step verification after entering your password. So let's start the demo. In this demo, we will do the two steps. We will create a free account with $300 USD in Google Cloud Platform
and we will walk through Google Cloud Console dashboard.
Let's start the demo for creating free tier Google Cloud Platform account. We will take you to the steps and walk through the dashboard. For this, you need to open URL cloud.google.com/free. Once you open this URL, you need to click on Get Started for Free, or you can click on Sign In. So once you click on Get Started for Free, it will take you to the login screen. Here you need to enter your Google account ID. If you do not have any, you can click the Create Account and it will take you to the account creation page, and you can create a new Google account. As suggested in presentation, please create a separate Google account for GCP Demo Labs.
Separate ID that I have created, I will mention here. Password of account. And it's asking for G code. Two-step verification. This is one-time code, so no use after that.
Once you provide your user ID and password, it will take you to the Google Cloud Platform page for registration. So this is our step one. It's asking you to select country, so we will select India. It's asking to accept terms and conditions. We will accept it and we will continue. It's redirecting us to step two. Now it's asking for account types. So our is individual account. You need to provide your tax information. PAN number and TAN number is optional. Here you need to provide your address. This is our demo account, so I am skipping the complete address, but for your environment or for your account, you can provide the complete address while you are registering on Google Cloud Platform for your projects or environment. So once you go down, it asking for payment methods. Here you need to provide your credit card details, and once you provide your credit card details, it will take you to the authentication page and it will charge some nominal amount from your card. But please don't worry, it will refund back to your card automatically in some time. This is only to registration purpose and verification purpose, and to ensure that this is not a robot who is doing this registration. So once you click on it, it will take you to the credit card payment authentication page. And once payment is successful, it will automatically redirect you to Google Cloud Console dashboard page. Due to security reasons, I am skipping the credit card payment part, but it will automatically take you to the dashboard page. So please register and we will meet you at the dashboard page. Hope you entered your credit card details, and also you see a warning that Google is going to charge you a small amount and it will going to be refunded. No worries about that, it's going to refund. So once you click your start free trial, you are in Google Cloud Platform console page. So welcome to Google Cloud Platform console page. This is the first time we are at Google Cloud Platform page, and this is the welcome message. And it's clearly saying your free trial period of $300 in credit to spend over next 12 months is enabled. So got it. This is our Google Cloud console dashboard page. So before taking a walkthrough to the dashboard, I'm going to sign out and sign it again to see the login process of Google Cloud Console page for future steps. So once you sign out, you need to browse the URL console.cloud.google.com. It will take you to the login screen.
Separate ID that I have created, I will mention here. Password of account. And it's asking for G code, two-step verification. This is one-time code, so no use after that.
After providing correct G code and successful authentication, it would automatically redirect you to Google Cloud Platform console page. So this is our dashboard and home page of Google Cloud Console. At top, you can see we have our information message, free trial status, along with credits and the days left to use it. So currently it's showing 21,406 Indian rupees, which is somewhere around $300. For the ease of the user understanding, Google automatically convert the credits into local currency and days remaining is 361 days are currently remaining. You can dismiss this message from here. This is our home page. So this is our Google Cloud Platform dashboard page. You can change the dashboard look and feel according to your requirement. You can move the cards like this, and you can hide the cards from here, or you can go to the customization if you want to hide or unhide multiple cards at what time, like this, or I want to enable this card. So it doesn't mean that once you hide the card you will not be able to. You just need to go to customize and you can enable it again once you click done. So your dashboard look and feel is changed. Activity, it will show the activities you have performed under this Google Cloud account profile. So there are list of activities I have done in last 4 days after creation of account. So creation of project, insertion of data, create data sets, update data sets. There are multiple things I have done. Also in notification, whenever you perform any activity, it will show the notification in notification bar. You can click here to see the free trial status again, and you can dismiss it back. This is the place from where you can browse all the available projects in your Google Cloud account. So currently we have 3 projects. If you want to create any new project, you need to click here. It will take you to the project creation page, and you can enter the name according to your wish. My first test project, and you can create it. See, the current project is creating, and it also comes in a notification bar. You can view it by click here. My first test project is mentioned in our initial session introduction to GCP. We know that project ID and project number is unique across the Google environment. In case I delete this project and this project is no longer active, still Google is not going to assign this project ID to anyone.
We have completed our today's lesson over free Google Cloud Platform with $300 USD free credits. For any questions or feedback, please leave comment on videos or contact us.
Thanks for watching. Do like, share and comment our videos. Also subscribe to our channel.